Okay, the today yesterday we discussed about fundamental of the VBA micro programming and objects, and we discussed about the workbook object. So tomorrow today we discussed about the seats and range object.
Okay.
Okay, so first for understand seat object, right? We are at the seat and go to the insert. Right, the seat object. What are the calling method of the seat object? First, know that, because the study I told you in the workbook I have a two method for the calling. First, work books, and second, active workbook. Right,
Yep.
like that. If we have the seat method, we have the three and four method of the seat calling. If you want to go on any another seat, say I want to active the seat one, so we have write the code seats and enter
Yep.
here seat one dot select,
Okay.
and we can
Okay.
also write here seat one dot sorry seat one dot select, and we have also
Yeah.
write seats one dot select, and three way of the seat calling method. This is the caption name, this is the property name, and this is the sequence number. So you have the caption name just like seat one. If you change the seat one to name is the month, right? So we have changed here seat one to month because our caption name will be changed, but your
Okay.
property name will be same, right? Property name changed by the VBA, not changed by the user, changed by the programmer. If you want to change the property name, then go to the seat one and here change the property name. So property name, mostly no need to change the property name, but caption name will be changed by user and changed by also mostly change caption name, seat caption name.
So all three will select the same sheet.
Same sheet. So this is the caption name, this is the property name. Property name that called, this is the property name, and this is the caption name. Understand?
Okay.
Every sheet have the two name, right? Every sheet have a
Okay.
two name. First name is the cap property name, and property name changed by the VBA, right? And
Okay.
in the bracket have a caption name, and caption name changed by the user in the Excel. It's like if you want to change the caption name, go to the seat and double click of the seat and change your name. This is the caption name.
Okay.
And
Okay.
third is the sequence number. If you don't know any property name, any caption name, then you can use the sequence number. That time our month seat have the position one, so this code active the this sheet. If you change the position just like that, yeah, I have moved seat two, sheet three, third position to one position. That time your this code active your seat three seats,
Okay.
right? The seat three,
Okay.
this is a seat sequence number, seat index number also called it.
So this one will act sheet three now.
Yeah, sheet three now. If you change the another, if you move to another sheet, then active the another sheet. So number one, any sheet on number one position, first sheet, then activate name and cap name and caption name and property name not required.
Okay.
And last, you know, active sheet. Base sheet you
Okay.
activated, they're called by active sheet. Right?
Okay.
Four way of the your call, seat calling method. So
Okay.
now we have discussed the some work with VVA on seat. First, you want to add your new seats. So right here, sheets dot add. Right, your seat will be added. But I want to add seat and add seat with name. So you can also write here and put your name equal to Jan. So this code will be add your seat with name Jan.
Okay.
Okay. But I want seat add to before of the your active seat. If you run this code, your seat add from the before of the active seat. If your seat is active to seat to activate, then this code add the new seat before of the two seats. Seat two. Sorry. Okay. But I want to add the seat with on position, you can enter seats dot add and press the where is the add before and after and enter.
I didn't follow seat dot add dot name and then what?
Seat this code add your seat with name Jan before of the active seat.
Yeah.
Just like if you enter a seat, then if you enter insert the seat, your seat will be inserted before of the active seat. Seat to activate. So we have entered inside the seat before the seat with name.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
But I want to add seat with on position. My position. I want to add the seat the fourth number. Yeah, after the last seat. Yeah, first seat. I will decide it. Okay, our seat, new seat will be insert before and after which seat. So we have add and press the enter and see here before and after, right? So I want to add the seat before of the month. You have entered here seats month, right? So this code add your new seat before of the month seat.
Okay.
And you can in this year you can also insert this method of the seat, right? Just like I want to insert the after, so you can also insert the one comma and skip the before, and now we have entered the add the new seat after the month. But I want to after the last seat, after the all seats, the last seat. So we have the five seats, so we have entered here five. So now, new seat added after the five, seat number five here. So new seat added here. After of the, every time last of the seat. But your seat count will be changed, increase and decrease also. That time, we have, you can enter here, seats dot count. Seat.count. So this code, you add your new seat after the all seat.
Okay.
And the last.
Okay.
Ma'am, wait a few minutes. Sorry, ma'am. We have the call. Take the call.
Okay.
So we have insert the new sheet, right? But every time you add the one only for one sheet, but you have required add the more than one sheet. You can also press enter here and use the comma and here is the count. If you have enter your five, then if you run this code, you have entered the five sheet in the last of seats.
Okay,
understand? Any doubt is this code?
Yeah.
Okay, so we have insert the new sheets, right? Then yeah. I want to move the sheet. We have, just like we have sheet here, I want to move this sheet to this position. So how can I move the sheet with positions? So we have name in the sheet, just like calling sheet calling method is a sheet one, then move. If you write only for write the sheet move, then this sheet move to new file.
Okay.
This sheet move to new file. Create the new file and move your sheets. Okay. Yesterday, I think you remember you, yesterday we have created the new macro, just like copy and paste, filter and copy and paste in new file. We have used code, move. And if you want to move in the same file, so we have entered here file sheet name, before and after. We have moved to before sheets, sheet 4.
Yeah.
Right. Then move sheet 4. But I want to move, if you keep the, keep the only for move sheet 1 dot move and not entering any moving position, just like move, then move to new file. If you enter the position, if you move in the same file with before and after your enter the sheet. But I want to move to another file, just like book 2, right?
Okay.
We have the book 2 and I want to move our month sheet to book 2 before of the first sheet.
Okay.
So we have write the code here. Sheet 1 dot move and enter here workbooks and enter the workbook name book 2 dot xls m dot sheet 1. Then our sheet move to workbook 2 sheet before of the sheet 1.
Okay.
So if you mention only for sheet name, then move to the active sheet. And if you give the your file reference, then move to that file reference. And you can also copy your file. There's a move that's like cut and paste, but you want to copy your file. Keep the one copy in the original file and send to the another way. Then just like the code will be same. Just like right here, copy, press of the move. And rules are the same. If you copy the same, copy to new file. And if you enter the copy with any sheet reference to then copy in the active workbook, and if you enter the any workbook name, then copy to this workbook. Enter the name.
Okay.
It is clear? Now we want to rename our sheets. So if you want to rename this like sheets month to year, so dot name and enter here sheets. Sorry, only for year. So if you run this code, your month sheet will be renamed to year. And if you want to delete your sheets, so enter your sheet 1 dot delete. But only for run this code, we have the display error. Just like if you run the deleting or sheet, we have got the alert.
Yeah.
So every time you will get the alert and your remaining code will really stop it. When you click on the deleted and then remaining code will be run. So if you use the delete code, so before the delete code, insert the one line application.
So hold on, the sheets month dot name is equal to year. What does it mean?
Our sheet name month change to year. Just like if you
rename. Okay. Yeah.
Right. And now we want to delete this sheet. So I have write the seed name, seed one dot deleted. But when you delete your seed, we got the alert.
Yeah.
And your rest of the remaining, if you have entered the any line of code below of the seed delete, then it will be stopped. Mm. When you click the delete, then delete your seed and run your enemy macro. This is a macro breakup. So when you use the delete code, so before the delete code, you have should be enter application dot. Okay, I have a spelling mistake. Application dot display alert equal to false. And one thing, when you apply the code, please write the code in the small and capital letter, not a both of mix. If you write the capital, keep the capital letter. If you write the small letter, keep the small letter, whole word. When you're pressing the enter and change the line, you get the your code will convert to title case. Just like A is the change the A capital letter, application A, display D, alert A. Then I think then this is the indication be your code will be correct. If you sometime if you write the code and your code will be error, code will be in the spelling mistake in your code, that time your sentence or code will not change to title case, right? Just like here, if we have write the spelling mistake, then see here S is the keep the small because not changed because this code will be wrongly. But I have entered the correct code, then press the enter, your S first letter will be changed to capital letter. So this is the indications your code will be correct.
Okay.
And if your code not changed to capital letter, maybe this code not exist. Otherwise, spelling mistake.
Okay.
So when you use your delete code, we use the application dot display dot equal to false. This is the application setting. Before the using this code, we have removed the alert system.
Okay.
Right? Stop the alert system. So right here code application dot display alert equal to false. So this code stop your application alert system, your applications. But this is the only for this macro, not all macro. Okay. If you start the code alert the macro, next macro will not get the alert. So no, only for change this subject of code. If you change the your code, the below of the disk, if you write the below of code, your alert will be not so.
Okay.
Right? But after this and sub, your setting will be keep the before like before.
Okay.
Okay. So we have delete your sheets. Now we want to hide your sheets.
Okay.
So we have write your code sheet one and visual. We have the two type of the hidden. First, normal hidden. If you write this code normal hidden, then just like user can hide the sheet, and user also unhide the sheet. Right?
Yeah.
But if you write the code here sheet one dot visual equal to very hidden. That time user can't unhide the sheet. Sheet will be unhided by code. Sheet unhided by the code. Just like sheet one dot visual equal to sheet visual. Right. This is the protection. If you apply this code, then programmer will be unhide your sheet. User not will be unhide your sheet. But maybe user if user know the VBA, you can also apply the code. You can protect your code through your tools. If you want to apply the protection of your code, nobody see your code and change your code. That time go to the reference, and this is the VBA project properties, and go to the protections, click on this log project for the viewing and apply the password.
Okay.
After that, when they open the your modules and code, ask the password. If you not enter the password, code will not display.
Okay.
And one thing remember, if you lost and forget the password, password it cannot be recovered. So if you enter the password, so keep your password remember. Right?
Yeah.
Okay. We have anhydrous sheet. And now we want to protect the sheet. Right? It's like just like sheet 1 dot protect. And enter your password. Your sheet will be protected. But we have also some other object. This is a member. It's a member details. We have the this all of the contain after the protection. What can will be the allowed?
Okay.
When they protect your password, give the password, and here ask to allowance. Allow user for worksheet 2. If you want to check the format cell after the protection, user can be format your cell, right? If you not check this, that user cannot format your cell. So here is if you want to allow the formats, so then you can also give the true. The drawing object, if you want to give the true, if you want to not, the skip your. Right. Comma, skip you.
What is protect here?
Sheet protections. You can't change the sheet.
Okay.
And if you want to unprotect the sheet, so enter your password dot unprotect and enter your password.
Okay.
Right. So we have see the calling method.
Yeah.
Add the sheet with name, add the sheet with count and positions, move the copy and move, and rename your sheets, delete your sheets, hide and unhide your sheets, and protect your sheet. And now last, if you want to print your sheets, then you can also print your sheets. You can also print, get the print preview, then you click on also print preview, right? And
okay.
I want to change the color, tab color, right? There's a like that, if you want to tab color, just like that. So you can also insert the tab color. Sheet1.tab.color equal to VV red, green, blue, sham, magenta, if you enter here.
Okay.
But we have the another way, just like sheet1.tab.color equal to RGB, red, green, blue. And we have entered the number of red, green, blue. RGB method. So, behind now question is, how can I identify red, what is the number of red, what is the number of green, and what is the number of blue? So that is helpful in Excel. When the apply the color, you have the more colors, right? And go to the custom, we have the red, green, blue. If you want with color which you want to apply, select here and go to the custom, see here the red number, green number and blue number.
Okay.
This is the RGB color method. But if but you want to some colors like green, like blue, cyan, magenta, green, white, you can also enter here VV green, VV red, VV red, white, VV blue, right?
Yeah.
Okay, this is the seed calling method. I think with your sheet, I have do what this type of the work. We have created the sheet, we have deleted the sheet. One thing we mean, if you want to select more than one sheet, just like if you select the more than one sheet, it's like three sheets, we have pressed the enter and select the three sheets. So how can? We have want to select the more than one sheet, how can select? So with VBA, you can write the code, array code, right? Yeah.
Okay.
Sheets, write here array, and enter in inverted comma, you have write the sheet name, sheet. Sheet, just like sheet name, just like year, comma, sheet 2, comma, sheet 3, and the last you can enter here, select. Now you have also entered the code activate. Sheet 1 dot activate, right?
Okay,
just like above the code we have write the select, you can also enter here the activate, because select with select your seat, one seat and more than one seat, right? But activate only, okay, for one seat.
Okay.
Okay, so this is the seat calling method, and we have used the some action on the seat, right? Next is the range. Before the use the range, I have mailed this code for the your practice. Wait a minute. This is the email ID?
Yeah.
Yeah, send you. Okay. And now we discussed about the range. Range is the important part, right? Please do the more practice in the range, because range is the important. Mostly work will be do with the range. If you copy the range, copy the data on the range, filter the data on the range, pivot of the data on range, apply the chart also on the range. So range is the very important.
Okay.
So first, know the what are the range calling method, right?
Mm-hmm.
You can, if you want to call to the just like range A1, so you have enter the code range A1 dot select, right? And you can also write the code sales 1,1 dot select, right? This is the alphanumeric and this is the R1 C1 inference style.
Okay.
Right. So you have also used the range and you have also used the cell.
Okay.
So first understand what the selection method, right? First know about the selection method with range. If you want to select the range A1, then use the also range A1. But I want to select the seat one range one. So you have entered here seat 1 dot select and range 1 dot select. right? First, okay. go to the seat one and then select the range one.
Okay.
But I want to select the book two, seat one range. Seat one range. Okay. So we have enter here first work, books, and enter here book one dot select. Activate. Yeah. So first book one dot, yeah, right, dot XLSM. So activate your book one file, and then activate your sheet, and then select your range.
Okay.
It is clear? If you select the active sheet, active file, active sheet only for write range one. If you want to select the active file, particular sheet and particular range, then if you enter your sheet and range, no need to workbook. But if you want to particular work to particular sheet to particular range, then if you need to write the code both of.
Okay.
Okay. This is the calling method, sheet calling method. And if you also write here active cell, just like active workbook, active sheets, then active cell. With your cursor, just like cursor here, then D3 is the active cell.
Okay.
Then active sheet. And also we have right here selection. Selection, just like active cell is the one cell, right? But if you select the one area, then the selection, that called selection with Excel, this is the selection.
Okay.
So this is the four calling method. First, apply your reference. Second, apply your R1C1 reference style. And third, active cell. And fourth, selection. And if you write the code here, if you select the active cell, active seats, any cell, then write the sim only for range. If you want to select the active file, any one seat, then write the seat name and range and particular file, then you can also enter the workbook name.
Yeah.
Now, we discussed about the selection method. We have right here some data. I want to select data. My data have A1 to H15. So you have right here two way. First, range A1 to H15, just like in the Excel formula.
Yeah.
We have apply a new formula. So select the range like that. A1 to H15. Right?
Okay.
So enter here H1 to A1 to H15. But with, you can also enter that. But VBA concept if A1 to H15. Right? This is the VBA method. This is the starting position or this is the ending position. So VBA, click on the first seat cell and place the shift and click on the last seat. This method use the VBA. Because if you select the dynamic range, then this method not applicable, but this method also applicable.
Okay.
And if you want to select multiple cell, just like select this cell, paste the control, select this cell, right? Multiple cells.
Yeah.
I want to select the choice as per me. Just like B1, press the control, select the D1, select the F1, select the H1.
Yeah.
Like the selection with VBA, we have write this code range A1 comma B1 comma D1 comma H1, right? The in the one inverted comma write the your cell address, then use the selected, your code will be selected.
Okay.
But I want to select the all data, right? All data. So we have right here code range A1 dot current region dot select.
Okay.
This is the control A. If we on the home menu bar, here is the go to a spatial and we have the current region. If you select the current region, select the, your entire used data.
Okay.
The used cell will be selected if you use the range one. But I want to select the whole sheet. Just like if you click here, you select the whole sheet. Then write the code cells dot selected. Okay. If you write the code cells dot select, select the whole sheets, right?
Yeah.
But I want to move the cursor, that's just like breakup. I want to move to start to end. Yeah, start to end of the right, end of the up. Then we use the range A1 to end. And where is the end? We have right here down. Then select the down. Right? So our cursor A1 to down.
Okay, what is up bound? Up bound, lower bound.
I explain up bound. This is a simple way.
Hello. Hello. Hello.
Hello. Now listen. Hello.
Yeah. Yeah.
So we have entered your end. And if you want to up, you can also hear up. Your cursor will be moved to up.
Okay.
Right. And here is the range. A15. Your cursor will be moved to another side. Excellent.
Okay.
Right and to left also. Right. But some problem in this code. If you have any blank data here, so how can select go to here? Because with AND code and Excel down code, if you press the enter and press the down arrow key, the cursor will be stopped here.
Yeah.
So how can you right here? That time we use the up method. Go to the last cell of the this column and press the control and up arrow. We have reached here.
Okay.
So we have enter your code. Range.
Yeah.
A 65,010 lakh as per your wish.
Yeah.
Dot and here is the Excel up then select. Right.
Okay.
And you can also, if you write the this same, then last go to the last and use the left cell.
Okay.
Okay. So I have used the selected method. It's like we have select this way or this way. We have used the control and shift, press the right arrow and press the down arrow. Select the data.
Okay.
So enter here range A1 in the starting position dot range A1 to end Excel to left.
Okay.
So this is the using the this method, right? The starting position and ending position. The starting position the A1 and ending position the this A1 to Excel left. And now we have select the first row of the your data and write the code range selection. Comma, starting selection and selection 2 and Excel down. Right? So selected your area, keep the control shift and down arrow. Your data will be selected. But problem is that also if you have blank any not fill the continuous data, then that time you this code run only for this area, not a complete area. Right. So we have used the sum method here. I have used the one variable name is R, and here use the range A65000 dot and X less up dot row. So last row number will be stored on the this variable.
What end up person? It's not last, right? It's first, right?
This is the last. Go to the last A65000 and end up. Last field data row.
No, see, yeah, go to that one and then end up person. It will go to the upmost row, isn't it?
Upmost row, yeah, it's right.
Yeah, so that is not the R is not going to be the last row. R is going to be the first row.
Yeah. R, this row number is stored in the R. R is the variable, right?
Yeah.
This is the variable object. Yeah. The string type of range type of the variable. Sorry.
Yeah. So range from range 65,000. If you end up, it is going to take the first row and put it the first row value into R. It's not going to put the last row value in R.
No, ma'am. For no first row, last edited data. This is the first go through 65 row, and here is the press control and press the up arrow and go to the last row of the data. Last row of the data, right?
Last row of the data. You said
row of the data and enter the row number on this. Keep them store the row number on R because we have to enter the row. Row is the property. So this location's row number will be stored on the R. R is our variable, our data type.
Okay.
And we have also applied here range XFT1 dot and Excel to right dot column. Right. So go to the last column here. This is the XFD1. And right here, press the control and press the right arrow key and go to our last column, last data column. Right. And its column number is stored on the C. So we have the last row number and last column number.
Okay.
Right. And we use this method, R1C1. This is in the number of the row and number of the column.
Okay.
So we have entered here range A1. Remember our data start from the A1. And for the end, we have entered here sales and row and comma C. Dot C.
Okay.
Your data will be dynamically selected.
Okay.
Right.
Yeah.
So this is the selection method. So
range A1, as in it's like the whole of A1, A row, cells R to C, as in like.
Just like the number. Okay, we have the number of 8 row. This is the column, is the 8 row column and 15 row. So first click on the starting of the A1 and press the shift and go to the 15 number row and 8 number colon and click here and select the all data.
Okay.
So this is the select your dynamically. If your data will be blank here, no problem, your data will be selected.
Okay.
Right.
Yeah.
Now we have covered the selection method. This is the selection method, right? We have that to cover the two topic. First topic is your seed calling method. And second topic is the range calling and selection method. And third topic is the how can write the data in your range.
Okay.
Right. So we have entered here subject RR. name will change. If you want to type the any data, it's like I want to type data here, your name. So right here, range A1 dot value. Dot value equal to name. You can also write here range A1 dot apply the dot symbol name, right? And you can also write here range A1 dot formula equal to name. So both are the same, right? Okay. But up enter the your name, enter your data in your active sheet. But I want to enter the data with another sheet, just like sheet 4. So right here, sheets 4 dot range A1 dot value equal to name. Right?
Okay.
But in the selection method, okay, I want to select your data. So I have first sheet sheet 1 dot activate and then range 1 dot select.
Okay.
So select is the error action. I have explained the last classes, study classes. We have three part of the member. First method, third property. First method, second event, and third property. This is the event. If you apply any event, event member on your object will be object one by one. At a one time, you can't apply the two object action, right? If you you can can't apply the sheet 1 dot range A1 dot select, this code will be wrong. We can't get, if you run this code, then get the error, right?
Okay.
So we have right here, first sheet 1 dot select and go to the range 1 slot.
Okay.
But with writing the your this is a value is the property, right?
Yes.
With property, you can directly write your object. If you want to enter your range particular sheet, you have directly you can enter the particular sheet. But if you want to enter the particular file, particular sheet, and particular range, then you can also write here work, books, and here book 2 dot xls x and range sheets range, and you have write the code on the. Hello?
Yeah, I'm there listening.
Okay. So you can write the code directly to any sheets, but your file will be open, right? Book 2 is not open, then go this code get the error, but your book will be open, but not be activated is fine, but enter here. So you can enter the any name, any value on the cell like that. But I want to apply the sum value to another cell, just like we have enter the H150 and I want to apply this value to A1, right? Yeah. So that time we have write the code. We write the code range A1. A1 the first because A1 the receiver. A1 dot value equal to range H1 because H1 the given, so after the equal.
Okay.
So receiver cell address, receiver object will be before of the equal and giver after of the equal. The H1 value is stored on the A1.
Okay. Right. Can you talk more about up bound and lower bound now?
I have explained the up bound and lower bound, but after this object, up bound and lower bound is the related to array. So first first understand the normal object, then understand the data types, then we discuss about the object.
Okay, fine.
Okay, so first understand that.
How long will this one go, this range thing?
Range is important. I think every class we use the on the range now.
Okay.
Okay, so for understand this thing, very important part, right? And okay. After that, we have created the one project, live project.
Okay.
Okay, so we have, if you enter this code, but you, in the object, we have the, any formula, just like 20 plus 50, right? So this code okay. Only for value, not a formula.
Okay.
That is semantic. But you have entered here the value, formula, that your cell formula will be copied to here equal 20 plus 50. Right?
Okay.
So this is the entering method. If you want to enter your data, you can also here. But I want to apply some formula. Just like we have the data here, 20, 60, 20, 80, right? I want to apply the sum formula, just like here, right? So you can also calculate the sum and enter your sum as a numeric. So use the from VBA, but I want to apply the formula, sum formula, like normal Excel formula. We apply here sum. So we have enter here code like that, range. A6 dot value equal to in the inverted comma we have entered here.
Okay,
applied formula, but sometime we have used the complicated formula, just like if this value is greater than 50, then show okay and pending. Right, if you want to show this formula, apply this formula. You can also apply this formula, but some kind of changing here. V1 dot value equal to in the inverted comma we have right here. But problem is that in the formula also have the inverted comma. So in the formula have the inverted comma, use the double inverted comma.
Okay.
Then your formula, though your VBA code understand this code will be also have an inverted comma and same right here, single inverted comma. Okay? Understood?
Okay.
So now we have created the one project that just like data sending. Okay. Go to the new file and this is the form or this is the data. So, serial number, date, time, sorry, right here, time, name, city, amount, right? And on the form, have the enter here, name. I have created a simple form. City and amount. Right, keep the blank, also blank, and also blank here. And now we have entered the name, we have entered the city, and we have entered the amount. And when they're pressing the one button, I have also created here a button, submit, like submit button. Click on the submit button, my those data store in my this data one by one. And also give the one sequence number and also give the date when your data will be added and also give the time when the data will get added.
Okay.
So for this data editing method and apply the selection method, this project. So see here, how can insert the modules first and apply some data. And yeah, right. First, we have created the sequence number. So ID equal to ID, ID equal to application. We have if you create the your sequence number, we have used the max. Max, okay. Apply this, select this code and plus one. We have got the sequence number. We write here one, then sequence number will be two. Two, three, right?
Yeah.
But problem is that max is not directly support the VVA. If you apply your ID equal to max. So max is not supply, not support the VVA programming.
Okay.
How can I identify max is not supporting VVA programming? Because if supporting the VVA programming, they show the expression. Like a lane formula is the support of your VVA, show your expression. Yeah. So if you want to apply this formula but not support the VVA, call to your worksheet worksheet function call to function directory. So here application dot worksheet function dot max and apply here range as per VVA sheet data dot range for the colon A, right?
Okay.
So I want to add the data here, sheet data. So right here, sheets data dot range A 50,000 dot and Excel up dot, sorry, Excel, the L, Excel up dot offset 1,0 dot value equal to ID plus one, right? So first go to the data sheet and go to the last column, last row of the column, that's like 65,000 and press the control and up arrow and go to the your
sheet.
Last row of the data and with offset change the row number and enter here the ID plus one, at least 0 plus 1 equal to 1. Yeah. Right? And we have also copied this and pasted here. And now we code will keep, but change the offset. This is the offset 1,1 and enter here today.
What is offset 1,0?
Yeah, right. Understand. Apply. Now we have go to the 65,000 last of the row and press the control and up arrow. Now our cursor will be here, not a serial number.
Okay.
And that time we have not give the command the down of the row. I have give the command to change the colon, next colon. Enter here your date. Right. So I called you, okay, this is the row number, this is the column number.
Yeah.
Now we have changed to column, not a row. Row is a zero, keep the row. If you go to the manual, it's like control and up arrow, our cursor go to the our last row number, and last cell ID.
Oh, okay. Date in the next. Okay, got it. Okay,
date is the next. Date is the next. We select the next. And date. And also, we have also keep the sequence as a like that. We have integer 2 and time. Right. So, in the VVA have a now formula for date and time, but not a time. But I have data demand to time, only for time. So in the Excel, we have also have a now formula. Right. Now with now formula, you got a date and time, and only for time we apply the text formula. In this text formula, have we write the custom formatting code, just like h slash m m slash colon ss, right? H for hour, m for minute, and s for second. We have got the only for time. But text formula also not supported the VBA, but like a text formula, have a formula format. Just like text formula. And we have entered here HH colon, MM colon and SS. To extract the only for time from the date and time.
Okay.
And now also enter here 3. And we have form B2. So right here, range B2 dot value. Right? Paste here is the 3 to 4, and after B2 have a C4 and C6. Right, delete here, copy, paste. Right, 4, and here, right here, B4, and also right here, 5, and here the 6. Right?
Okay.
This all code will explain, understand?
Range B2, as in what is that? Range B2 value?
B2 value, V2 value store in the data, your data sheets.
Oh, okay.
Okay. And after complete node, got the meshes. So right here, meshes, MSG box, and enter your data have saved. And after data saved, I want to clear our form. So range here, apply a range. B1, comma. B2, B4, comma, B6, right?
Okay.
Dot clear. Clear contain. In the selection method, I will explain if you select the multiple cells, then use this method.
Okay.
Clear contain. Now, I want to create the one button, command button. Go to the developer tab and insert. We have the form control, right? To create the, yeah. Select the form control button and create the button. After the draw your button, ask to the assign macro. We have select your data and okay, right? You can also change, right click, edit text. You can also change here, save. Right, click on this button. Data have been saved and your data will be saved at this here.
Yeah.
And now, but our data not clear.
Now, can you go back to the code again? Sorry. So here, application, the first one, ID is equal to application.worksheet function.max. So
this is the formula, right? Max formula. So check the your data sheet colon A, the maximum value.
Yes. Take the maximum value in that column and then add 1 to it.
1 to the next your maximum number, because I want to create a sequence number one by one. So I apply here and plus add 1.
Yeah, okay.
And also the system date and also the time. But we have the problem for the time. We have not any formula for the only for time, not in Excel and not in VV also. So now formula is the date and time. So apply the format and extract the only for time. But with this code.
Yeah.
Or enter the set value. And then we have apply the, give the value V2, V4 and V6. But one problem here, if we have not mentioned the seat name here. Only for the range.
Yeah.
Because we have run this macro when click on the button. And if you click on the button, your form will be activated. So no need to give the worksheet reference on this code. Because our active sheet will be also form. And I want to save the data from the form. Just like save and OK. The data will be clear and your data will be saved, sequence number 2. OK, ma'am?
Yeah.
But this code will be understand when you create the one form. So I think if today stop the class now, and we have sent this file to you and code also to you.
And yeah, I have the a one doubt. Live form.
Yes.
That's okay. I have one doubt. With regard to my work.
Okay, tell me.
I want to share the screen and show you something.
Okay, no, please wait.